hours. But so just anyone who wants to have a quick reflection on how it feels to see the film on a big screen. I think that there will be some lights coming on. Maybe Jack can follow up on that for us. Thanks, Jack. Anyone want to start off with some impressions? How do you feel?
I think there, yeah, that was really emotional. That was the first time we watched it on a big screen with other people that weren't the community or our family and friends. So, I don't know, it's kind of crazy to finally be standing here after 3 years. I mean, the film that you saw led up to opening night of the play, and the play debuted in April of 2016. And since then, we've been continuing to make the film, and as the situation has evolved, we've kept adding things to the film, even up until the point, as you saw in the end credits, where you know we had to address the recent escalation of violence against the Rohingyas. So it was just really emotional. You know, we've been through a lot making this film, and it's so rewarding to finally be here with the cast and with the parents and with all of you, and it's just amazing.
Hi everyone, I'm Jenna. To be honest, this film, like, oh my god, I don't even know how to describe it. Oh my god, like, I didn't expect it would be this good, actually, first of all. But I mean, like, this is actually the true story of, like, our parents, of us. So I really appreciate it. And, like, I'm surprised seeing you guys. Like, I think this is, like, a huge audience that, like, I don't know, my heart is just, like, beating so fast. Like, just like first time watching with you guys too. Like, I mean, I was like cast too, but like I think they were like there to watch it, but like I didn't get the chance to go watch it. But like this is my first time. I'm actually so surprised and very impressed and very proud of my friends here who put so much effort and you know raising their parents' voices around the world and. They're very proud of us, like our parents are very proud of us, and I'm glad they're proud. This is like a chance for me to do something for my parents. I mean, like, they have always supported, they sacrificed everything for us to get in a separate place, which they did. And I think, like, this is the only gift that we can give to them since we have nothing sacrificed from our life. So yeah, thank you so much. Like, I really appreciate you guys coming in to listen to our story, and I hope you guys share the story with others too. So thank you so much.
Well, my name is Mama Roma, as I mentioned on there. I am actually so happy that we got to see the movie again. This time on a bigger screen than last time, a tiny screen. And I'm really happy because I never knew we would get this much audience. Can I not talk to you? I'm so happy because we got so many audience today, and then I'm happy that we can finally share our story with all of you in Ottawa and other places too. And I'm also happy because now I can finally say I have done something to show what's going on, and like it's not, we're not just staying silent, and yeah. So
I'm not crying, okay?
I'm just really happy we get to show our stories to you guys.
I won't take too long, and I was sitting down and I'm standing. First of all, I would like to thank all of you guys for coming out. You know, when you go back to 2015 summer of 2015, when we met Yusuf, all of this was just a talk, some fantasy that we have drawn out in our own mind someday to explore. And today, people like yourself actually coming to see a project that we actually fantasize about. So that gives me a lot of hope that this is one of the reasons why we did the play. People like yourself, caring, such caring people. You guys need to know what is going on in Myanmar. All of these people are suffering. Nobody chose that life. All of this is being forced upon them. I did not choose to be a Rohingya refugee. I do not choose who I want to be born to. I do not choose what religion my parents will practice before I was born. I am not a criminal. I am just a child, just like everybody else. I have as much right as everybody else in this world to exist. Today, there's 150 of you guys here. Tomorrow, that will multiply. And I promise you, these kids here, these 13 of us, I promise you, I'll say with my pride, I'm gonna cry out right now. I'll say it with pride that these kids will write history. We will not be silent, and nobody's going to stop us. We will continue. We'll continue to stand our grounds. We'll continue to fight with help or without help. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Mohammed Jabed. I am a Rohingya. When I first joined this play, I was nervous, so shy. I was losing my mind at the same time. At school, I would tell my friends that I can't come to school for some days because I'm nervous about this play. The first time I did it, I was nervous. My mom told me, why do you have to be nervous? It's just a play. And then I was worried the movie would come out like bad and everything. But I'm like, damn, Gene.
Myself and everyone here, I've seen myself in a big screen. I just want to say. Our goal is to bring peace back in our back home, and I think I'm getting some good feeling now. The only way people like you make us come all the way here, and you watching us our history. And please help us to take the next step so we can accomplish our goal. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Mohammed Sohal. I only have one thing to say is that what we just watched is a message. So I want each one of you to go out today and tell everyone about Rohingya. Thank you. All the options are taken. Is there like any other questions?
We can open it up. I don't know if the three of you at the beginning wanted to say anything. Here, let me grab that mic.
Come on, Kevin, you gotta say something.
I mean, I can't say much other than it was amazing to get to know this community. Of course, like the film and doing the play. I came in, you know, months after Yusuf started creating the play. I came in to film, and I basically filmed the whole process. We didn't really know what we were going to do with the footage. We just knew the story had to be told. So over the past 3 years, it turned into this, and it was amazing to get to know all of you, your families. You know, I think I can speak for all of us to say, you know, this is an amazing group of people. You guys did all of it. We did. Yeah. So.
Yeah, I mean, I think what, and I'm sure it goes the same for the two of you as well, is, you know, just editing this film, we watched it so many times amongst the three of us, and it remains as inspiring today as it did, you know, when we first met this group of kids, the first time we saw a rough cut of the film, and when we, you know, burned it onto the Blu-ray. We're sold a narrative, I think, in our culture that when refugees come to Canada, they are immediately absolved of their trauma, but that just disappears. And I think what we witness throughout the making of this film, and hopefully what we've communicated through it, is that these experiences stick with these kids in ways that are both incredibly debilitating, but also in ways that are very constructive. You know, there's this a distinct sense of altruism that has worked its way into, you know, all spheres of their life. For example, their professional ambitions, Ruma and Parveen wanting to become, you know, nurses and work in medicine because of what they witnessed in camps, and, you know, Faisal's, you know, ambition to become a police officer because of the corruption he witnessed in refugee camps, and Rysel's goal of using his platform as a professional athlete to raise awareness for the cause. It's inspiring is just the only word I have for it, and we are just incredibly blessed to have witnessed this journey, I think.
Hi, my name is Samantha McGavin. I work with Interparis, and I just wanted to share how incredibly moving I found the play to be, and your clips from the camps in Bangladesh took me back to when I was there in November, and I had the chance to meet people and to walk around and to hear some of those stories, and it's just so incredibly sobering to think that every person I talk to, if you think of the 14 people here, everybody has